So this is the login to our DNA software application portal. It's easy to register if you haven't registered already. But you come into the portal and you can see our three products that we have: qPCR copy count, which is for analysis of PCR to get absolute quantification; thermoblast, which is a standalone product that you can use for checking primers that you may already have at your organization; and PanelPlex, which is what I'm talking about today. So let's go ahead and design some solutions with PanelPlex by clicking on the blue button. And let's go ahead and now run PanelPlex. The PanelPlex has four different steps. First, we need to choose our panels, our playlist, the inclusivity, exclusivity, and background. And we need to choose this thing called the keystone, which I'll explain in a moment. Once we've entered those, we'll be talking a little bit about the details of the target. Either do we want to design to the whole region or the whole target or a region of the target. And we'll give the hybridization conditions and any probe modifications. All right, so here are the basic steps for doing the design in PanelPlex. The first is that we need to choose our panels. So I've already set up inclusivity and exclusivity lists for the Zika virus. So they're already here, and we have a separate webinar that we've given on thermoblast. This is the same interface here that we have in thermoblast for creating playlists and for accessing them. And for today's talk, I'm not going to talk about how to create the playlist. It's very simple, but we're not going to show that. I'm going to instead just show you the results. So here's an inclusivity playlist for Zika virus, for example. It has all 168 Zika viruses, and here they are. All of them are listed. You can see them are on, you know, several different pages here of Zika virus variants. And we're going to choose that to be our inclusivity list for today. All right, so it's as simple as just hitting select as inclusivity playlist. Wait until that takes that in. And now we have the exclusivity playlist. So I've already prepared this exclusivity playlist for Zika. So let's go ahead and view that one just to give you a sense. This Zika playlist has 5,443 near neighbors, other flaviviruses and fever-causing viruses that are somewhat related to Zika virus that we want to make sure don't cause false positives. So for example, we can see some examples of dengue fever virus, chikungunya, which is actually not so related, it's a toga virus, but it's still a fever-causing virus, and several other viruses that you can see here in this list that are related to Zika virus that we would not want to cause a false positive. All right, so that has been pre-done, so I just choose that as the exclusivity playlist. I'm going to wait until that registers for a second. There we go. All right, so we've now chosen our inclusivity and exclusivity. Last step is to choose the background sequence. In this case, I want to make sure that any Zika diagnostic I design does not bind to the human genome. So the human genome, I choose that as my background sequence. I just did a little search here out of all our playlists. I just listed every playlist that involved the humans, and here they all are. The first one on the list is human genome, so I selected that. All right, so I've selected now my three different playlists. All right, and those are going to be used by the software to determine the coverage and the background and all those other features. I'll say more about that in a moment. All those things we talked about as four problems are going to be addressed by the software. So next is this issue of the keystone. I haven't talked to you about what a keystone is, but here it is here. The definition is given right at the top of this page. The keystone sequence is one of the sequences from the inclusivity playlist that you want to detect with primers that have no mismatches. Typically, you would choose a reference genome that is biologically or historically considered to be the most important sequence in your list. Now, we have three different ways that you can choose a keystone sequence, but this is the sequence that is going to be sort of the center of the design, and things, variants thereof will go around that design. But even if you choose a bad keystone, the software is smart. It will try other keystones as well and compare them to yours. If you hit the select keystone, it will try several different keystones, including yours, to see which one works best. So in this case here, I have a starting keystone. That was what I had cued myself to remember. Before I plugged it in, this is just showing you the complete list of inclusivity sequences. Now I put this accession in it, zeroed in on the one that I want to use. So that's what I'm going to use as my keystone. All right, next. So here we are on the target details page. We need to give this job a name. I'm going to call it the Zika Demo 2. All right, so that's the name of my job. Lastly, we're going to choose what type of detection we want to use. If this was an NGS application, we would choose no probes because you just want to amplify the target. If we want to detect them with a fluorescent probe like a TACMAN probe, we choose probe here. Now the next option is, do you want to detect the whole target, in which case the software will check the entire Zika virus, which is over 10,000 nucleotide region length, and it will try to find the best places for design. Or we can choose a design range. Now we allow design ranges up to 40,000 nucleotides. Now in this case, the Zika virus is 10,000 nucleotides. We could say, oh, please direct our design to, maybe we know where there's a gene. Maybe it goes from 50 nucleotide 1500 to nucleotide 2500. Okay, it would limit the design to that region if you did that. This is a capability that can be used to, for example, use PanelPlex to design to a bacterial target. So bacteria are too big to design the whole target because they're millions of nucleotides long, but you can narrow your region down to 40,000 nucleotides, which is as big as any gene or gene region that just about anyone would ever want to design to. And certainly most viruses are shorter than 40,000 nucleotides. You could also use this to do a target in the human genome. Lastly, we have to choose our hybridization conditions. And I have one that I made up here for Zika. This is just a standard PCR condition in terms of the sodium and magnesium that are present in the solution. Okay, lastly, you can assign modifications to your probe. In this case, TACMAN probes, I could choose fluorescein as the 5' end fluorophore and BHQ quencher as the 3' end quencher. And that's it. You hit run and the job is submitted. All right, at this point, this program is going through millions and millions of computations that are being done on 32 CPUs. All right, you can see the program automatically took us to the results page. And here's the project I just started, Zika Demo 2. It says not started. It takes about 60 seconds or so to spin up a dedicated 32-core instance on the cloud to solving your problem that will crunch away on it until it creates your solution. In the process, it's folding all of those sequence variants of the Zika virus. It's trying tens of thousands of primer candidates. It's doing hybridization reactions to those Zika viruses. It's checking for all the false positives against all the members of the exclusivity set, the dengue fever viruses, West Nile viruses, all the other things you put in that. It's checking to make sure that those primers don't bind to the human genome. Well, this job takes about 8 hours to run, and I ran one last night. I started it at 4 p.m., and it was ready this morning when I came in, and I wanted to show you the results. So we can see here that the first solution it found involved two primer sets, and I'll highlight them here. Here are the two primer sets that it used to cover all 168 different sequences. And you can see individually the first set of primers, which I'll highlight, this first set of primers was able to cover 96% of the Zika variants. And you can go in, the software does show you what those variants are that were covered by that primer set. And what you can see now is the second set of primers took the cumulative coverage from 96% to 100%. So the second set of primers, shown here, by themselves, that set of primers covered 85% of the Zika virus genomes. But together, the two primers together, have been designed to not interfere with each other and to completely solve the problem and have a cumulative coverage of 100%. I mentioned that we have a set of not just one solution to the multiplex problem, but here's a second solution with three primer sets were required to solve that one to get a cumulative 100%. Here's one with four different primer sets that were required. Here's one with three primer sets, et cetera. Here's one more down here with two primer sets. It's actually an excellent solution as well. If you're a user who's interested in knowing what the heck, what is it that is special about these sequences? Well, if you hit view details, this is where all that information that I shared with you about the folding of the DNA, folding of the RNA target, folding of the amplicon, all right? We have a set of scoring metrics here that are giving us the bimolecular folding energies, unimolecular folding energies, all that stuff is integrated into the scoring equation. Everything is for you where you can see where these scores came from. You can also look at the coverage here if you want to see how well do these primers cover the different targets. You hit view coverage link over here, and it takes you to this page. And it shows you how the primers cover the inclusivity set. You click over here, you can see how they cover the exclusions that you don't want it to cover, etc. Now, all of the detailed information, you can also download as CSV files. So for example, all this information about the solutions, you can just hit download solutions as CSV, and voila, it will download that CSV file. All right, we can take a look at that file. So I can see that if I want to see it in my downloads, here it is. I can open up that file, and it has all of that sequence information. So you can just cut and paste and order those oligos and test them out. If you want to order a particular solution, you just order across a row like that. Order those oligos, test them, you should be good to go.